Hi, my name's Frank Valentic and welcome to our Advantage Market Fortnightly Update. Hope you had a happy festive season and wish you all the best for the new year. Hope it's a great one for you. Well, the Melbourne market finished 2014 relatively strongly considering there was a large volume of stock on the marketplace. The clearance rates averaged in between about 67 to 70% in the latter part of the year, and that was natural that they'd come back a little bit from the 75% averages earlier because there was a lot of stock on the market. There was over 10,000 auctions in the last 7 weeks. So there was a lot of stock to be absorbed, and that was only natural. I was asked to provide some quotes in the Smart Company magazine, whether this was the start of the next downturn, and I really don't think so. There was some big record results across the marketplace. We saw a block of flats in Elwood sell for $900,000 above the reserve price in Pine Avenue, which is definitely not the signs of a down market. In Bondi, in Sydney, there was the highest apartment sale ever in history. An apartment sold for over $21 million, which was a massive figure. The apartment was 570 square metres in size, so it equated to $35,000 per square metre, which is amazing. In Melbourne, for instance, if we compare how affordable we are, prestige apartments in Wall Street, South Yarra, in the Botanical Gardens precinct are selling for around $18,000 a square metre, so it's about half the price of the Sydney Bondi apartment. Looking ahead, my predictions for this year, 2015, are that the market keeps on going and it keeps on improving. House prices went up nearly 16% in Melbourne in 2014, and apartments and units went up 8%. I think those numbers will be moderate this year. House prices in most areas, good quality homes, seeing 5 to 10% growth, and apartments, depending on where they are and what type of apartment they are, seeing 5 to 8% growth in most parts of Melbourne. There's positive news for the property market. Four of the major banks have now come out and said they expect a rate cut in the first half of 2015. And there's no one talking about any interest rate rises. And this has been the longest sustained period in Melbourne's history where interest rates haven't moved at all for over 19 months. If interest rates drop further, and they're already at 40-year lows, that'll only spur the market along to be a lot stronger in 2015. So how do you negotiate a good deal? I was asked to provide some tips for Australian Property Investor magazine recently, so I provided a few tips. And one of them for me is making sure that you can make strong unconditional offers. So that involves having a pre-approval in writing beforehand, having a deposit ready to go, organising a building report, organising to have the contracts checked by a solicitor so that you can make a really solid offer. And like the Jerry Maguire movie, show me the money, he used to say, put it on the contract, put it in front of the vendor and present it with a deposit check to show that you are serious, and it'll give you a much better chance of securing a deal. We purchased three properties before auction late last year in Oakley, at Keilor East and Brighton, and we were able to negotiate good opportunities before auction by presenting strong unconditional offers. My hotspot tip for this month is the areas of Glen Iris and Malvern East. You know, they're bordering out that 10 kilometre radius and really benefiting from the ripple effect of the more expensive inner suburbs such as Armidale, Malvern, Hawthorne, South Yarra, and clients that maybe can't afford those inner areas or looking for better value for money can go out a bit further and get some fantastic value. We've still got some opportunities of some one-bedroom apartments in our group blocks purchase in Edgar Street, Glen Iris, and they're on our website. If you want to check out our current and future opportunities, head to our website. The boys' apartments on the block, Shannon and Simon's property, we leased recently through our rental department and got a fantastic result for our investor clients. It was only on the market for a week. We had a number of applications that came in. We were asking $1,750 per week as a rental. We ended up negotiating a great return for our client of $1,900 per week. And this is also benefiting from the depreciation benefits, which is about another $1,300 a week, totaling $3,200 a week return for our investor clients. So they were delighted. Return of about 8.5% when you work it out as a return. So a fantastic investment return for our investor client there. So thank you for listening to our Advantage Market Update, and look forward to seeing you again.